Hello, my name is Swati Srivastava Bhadauria. Welcome to my life page. Today, I shall talk about IAS. So let me give you a quick background about myself. I did my schooling from Little Fly School in Gorakhpur. Thereafter, I did my BTech in Electronics and Communications Engineering. I worked with the Reserve Bank of India for 6 months while I was preparing for a civil services exam. In 2012, I joined IAS. Earlier, I was allotted to Chhattisgarh cadre, which after marriage was changed to Uttarakhand in 2015. And in Uttarakhand, I took up various jobs like SDM Masuri, and thereafter I was posted as SDM Dehradun. And currently I am working as Additional Secretary, MSME Department plus Additional CEO in Khadi and Village Industries Board, Uttarakhand. Let's start by talking about what IAS is. We'll just briefly talk about what this service, Indian Administrative Service, is all about. Let me explain in brief. Recruitment in this exam is done through UPSC by Union Public Service Commission. It offers you 24 services out of which you have to select anyone. Mostly people who write this exam choose IAS, IPS or IFS as their topmost priority. So we'll be talking about IAS, which is a generalist service. It offers a lot of exposure from the day you join the service. It offers you a very diverse job profile. First of all, you are generally posted as SDM, which is Subdivisional Magistrate. Thereafter, for a year or two, you are SDM of a subdivision. Thereafter, you are promoted generally to CDO, which is Chief Development Officer, in which you look after the developmental affairs of the district you are posted in. Then generally, you are given the charge of a district magistrate. These are the major three jobs at the field level. And once you are done with the field level, then you are given the charge of additional secretary as well as secretary in the secretariat. Not only this, this job also offers you various job profiles in public sector undertakings as well as foreign postings in World Bank, United Nations, etc. It can even offer you inter-cadre deputation to other states as well as central deputation to the central government. Let's now talk about the education required for being a good IAS officer. Not much can be gained from theoretical readings. However, for a beginner's training, a few subjects do come in handy, which we are talking about. First of them is law.